Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with Syncfusion Word Library in a Blazor Server application. DocIO is a native .NET Word library that is used to create, read, write, and convert Microsoft Word documents to other file formats. To explore other features in our DocIO library, please refer to the link in the card above. In this video, I am going to explain how to create a Blazor Server application in Visual Studio 2022 and add the Syncfusion DocIO NuGet package to the application. Also, I will explain the steps to create a Word document with text, images, tables, and finally save that Word document. Before proceeding, make sure you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine. You should also have one of these IDEs installed. Now, let me start building the application. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor Server App. Usually, the Word library works on both server and client-side deployments. But I prefer to use server-side deployments since the client-side deployment increases the application payload size. I proceed with the project creation by clicking the Next button and naming the project DocIO Blazor. Then, I continue with the default target framework and click the Create button to complete the project creation. Now, my application is created and is ready to use. In this application, I need to add the DocIO library to create a Word document. As a first step, I need to install the Syncfusion DocIO NuGet package. Open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for syncfusion.io.net core NuGet package and install it in my project. I click OK to complete the installation. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion trial license key in my application. For that, I open the program.cs file and register a valid license key using the register license method. To see where to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description. Look at this Word document with text, images, and table. I am going to create a similar Word document using the DocIO library. So, let's see the steps to achieve this. Before demonstrating the Word document creation process, I want to show you how it will be implemented in this application. The plan is to generate the Word document when the button is clicked. To do this, I open the Index Razor component and remove the existing code. Next, I add a header tag and a paragraph tag with their respective contents. I also define a button component with the content, Create Word Document, and set the button type to primary by defining the class attribute and setting its value to primary. Now, let me run the application to see how the changes are reflected in the output page. Look, the defined content and button component are displayed in the home page. As I said earlier, I am going to generate a Word document by clicking this Create Word Document button. To do that, first I add the click event to the button with the event handler create word. Then in this code directive I define the event handler create word. And, within this event handler, I am going to invoke the methods to create and save the Word document. I will now proceed to add a code to create a Word document, and once it is done, I will come back here and call that method. As a first step, I create a class called WordService under the data folder. Then, within this class include the Syncfusion DocIO and DocIO DLS namespaces to use the DocIO library. I will be inserting an image into this Word document, similar to the one shown in the sample document. To access that image files from the application location at runtime, I require a web hosting environment. So, let me define the variable hosting environment of type iWebHostEnvironment. Then, add constructor for this class. And initialize the web hosting environment variable within this constructor. I will now begin the process of creating a Word document. First, I define a method called createWord with return type memorystream. And then, create an empty Word document instance within this method. Usually, a Word document contains at least one section. So add a section to the Word document by calling the addSection API. Then, I set the page margins to 72 points. And custom page size. Next, I will be inserting paragraphs into the document. Before that, I need to create the styles that can be applied to them. So, I create a paragraph style called normal style. And define the font properties and the paragraph spacing values for this style. In the same way, I create another paragraph style called heading 1. And apply the normal style as the base style. Then I specify font customization using font properties like font size, text color, and the paragraph spacing values. Okay, I have created paragraph styles. Now let's proceed to add the paragraphs to the document. To begin, I add a paragraph to the header of the document. Then, apply the normal paragraph style. And set the horizontal alignment for this paragraph. As previously mentioned, I am going to add a picture to the document. So, I retrieve its location using the web hosting environment variable and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then, I append the picture to the paragraph by using this file stream object. For this image, I define the text wrapping style and positioned the image using the horizontal and vertical position properties. Next, I add text to the paragraph. And customize its appearance by setting font properties such as the name, size, and color. Now, let's see the output of this code by saving the document. To save the document, I first create a memory stream. And then call the save method, passing the stream and the desired document format type as arguments. This will save the document to the memory stream in the specified format. After saving the document, it is important to release the memory consumed by the Word document instance, so I call the close method. And reset the memory stream position to start reading or writing the data from the beginning again. Finally, return the memory stream. Now, let's proceed to see the output of this code by invoking this createWord method. To do that, I move back to the IndexRaiser component and import the namespace for this project so that I can use the WordService class. Also, I need to inject the web hosting environment instance to get information of the environment in which the application is running. Within this button event handler, I create an instance for the WordService class. And call the createWord method to create a Word document. As I said earlier, the generated Word document will be saved from the browser. To perform this action, it is necessary to call the JavaScript function, because there is no built-in functionality in Blazor application to save files. To invoke the JavaScript function, I inject the JavaScript runtime instance and use the same to call the saveAsFile function. Then, I need to define this function, so open the host.cshtml page. And add the saveAsFile function in the script tag. To know more about this function, refer to the link in the card above. Okay, let me save the changes and run the application to see the Word document created. See, when I click this button, the generated Word document is downloaded in my system. I open this document. And you can find the added text and image in the header. Now, let's proceed to add the remaining content to the Word document. First, navigate to the Word Service class. And to the section, I add a paragraph using the AddParagraph API. Then apply heading 1 style to the paragraph and set the horizontal alignment to center. Now, I add the text content to this paragraph and specify its font name and font size. Similarly, I add few more paragraphs to the Word document with specific font styles. Okay, the changes are made. So let me save and run the application. You can see the newly added paragraphs in the generated Word document. So far, I have shown you how to add image and text content to the Word document. Next, I will demonstrate the steps to add a table to the Word document. Inside this Word Service class, I add the table to this section using the AddTable API. And specify the required number of rows and columns using the resetCells method. Here, I created a table with 2 rows and 2 columns. Here, I am going to display the table without border, so set border style to none. I also set the auto resize property to true, so that the table size will adjust automatically based on the content. I add a paragraph to the first cell of the table. And customize it by setting after spacing and font size properties. Then, I use the basePath variable to retrieve the image location and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Using this file stream object, let me append the picture to the paragraph and modify its text wrapping style and positioning properties. Next, I will add content to the second cell in the first row. First, add a paragraph to the second cell. And customize it by applying the paragraph style and spacing values. Then, I append the text to this paragraph. In the same way, I add more text to the second cell, including font properties. Finally, I will add content to the second row in the table. For that, I copy the content from the second cell of the first row. And in that, modify the cell and row indices. Then I modify its text. For the second cell, I copy the picture from the first cell of the first row. And modify the picture name and positioning values. I have finished adding content to the Word document, and now let me show you the final output. When I open the downloaded document, you will see the new table with 2 rows and 2 columns. Let me recap what I have shown so far. I showed you how to create a Blazor Server application in Visual Studio 2022. You saw how to create a Word document using the DocIO library. I also showed you how to add the text, images, and tables to a Word document. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.